We just need to find this creature and determine what it... That is disturbing.
We are going to need bigger guns.
Invaders, your every step is a transgression. A thousand feelers appraise you as meat, good only to dig or decompose. I speak for the old growth as I did for Saren. You are within and before the Thorian. It commands that you be in awe.
You gave something to Saren. Something I need.
Saren sought knowledge of those who are gone. The old growth listened to flesh for the first time in the long cycle. Trades were made. Then cold ones began killing the flesh that would tend the next cycle. Flesh fairly given. The old growth sees the air you push as lies. It will listen no more.
Give me what I need, and I'll strike back at the one who betrayed you.
No more will the Thorian listen to those that scurried. Your lives are short, but have gone on too long.
Kill them all.
Your blood will feed the ground in the new growth.
Thank you.
That's it. Bag him and tag. Shepard.
I suppose I should thank you for releasing me.
How did you end up inside that thing?
My name is Shiala. I served Matriarch Benezia. When she allied herself with Saren, so did I. Benezia foresaw the influence Saren would have. She joined him to guide him down a gentler path. But Saren is compelling. Benezia lost her way.
Are you saying Saren can control minds?
Benezia underestimated Saren, as I did. We came to believe in his cause and his goals. The strength of his influence is troubling.
Benezia sought to turn the river and was swept away.
Asari matriarchs are among the most intelligent and powerful beings in the galaxy. How could one fall under Saren's control?
Saren has a vessel, an enormous warship unlike anything I've ever seen. He calls it Sovereign. It can dominate the minds of his followers. They become indoctrinated to Saren's will. The process is subtle. It can take days, weeks, but in the end, it is absolute. I was a willing slave when Saren brought me to this world. He needed my biotics to communicate with the Thorian to learn its secrets. Saren offered me in trade. I was sacrificed to secure an alliance between Saren and the Thorian.
Then why were the Geth trying to destroy the Thorian?
After Saren had what he needed, the Thorian became a liability. Saren knows you are searching for the conduit. He knows you are following his steps. He attacked the Thorian so you could not gain the cipher.
What's the cipher? And why did Saren need it?
The beacon on Eden Prime gave you visions. But the visions are unclear, confusing. They were meant for a Prothean mind. To truly comprehend them, you must think like a Prothean. You must understand their culture, their history, their very existence. The Thorian was here long before the Protheans built this city. watched and studied them. When they died, it consumed them. They became a part of it.
So the Thorian taught Saren to think like a Prothean. How?
The cipher is the very essence of being a Prothean. It cannot be described or explained. It would be like describing color to a creature without eyes. To understand, you must have access to endemic ancestral memory. A viewpoint spanning thousands of Prothean generations. I sensed this ancestral memory, the cipher, when I melded with the Thorian. Our identities merged, our minds intertwined. Such knowledge cannot be taught. It simply exists.
I need the cipher.
There is a way. I can transfer the knowledge from my mind to yours, as I did with Saren. Try to relax, Commander. Slow, deep breaths. Let go of your physical shell. Reach out to grasp the threads that bind us, one to another. Every action sends ripples across the galaxy. Every idea must touch another mind to live. Each emotion must mark another's spirit. We are all connected. Every living being united in a single, glorious existence. Open yourself to the universe, Commander. Embrace eternity. I have given you the cipher, just as it was given to Saren. The ancestral memories of the Protheans are part of you now.
Are you all right? What just happened?
I saw something. It still didn't make any sense.
You have been given a great gift, the experience of an entire people. It will take time for your mind to process this information.
We should get you back to the ship where you can be monitored.
I'm sorry if you have suffered, but there was no other way. You needed the cipher. In time, it will help you understand the vision from the beacon.
Now that you're free of the Thorian, what are you planning to do next?
If you allow it, I would like to stay here with the colonists. They have suffered greatly, and I played a role in their suffering. I would like to make amends.
The colonists will need all the help they can get. They'll be happy to have you on their side.
Thank you, Commander. May fortune smile upon you.
You did it. With the Thorian gone, we can start rebuilding for ourselves again. And we're free of Exogeny's threats. We're back to being just a little nowhere colony. Thank you, Commander.
We'll start over.
Oh, thanks again. That data will be very valuable once I get out of here. Hopefully everyone leaves us alone for a while.
I hope Exogeny learned from this.
I fought so hard, but any thought of my own caused so much pain.
I will do what I can to assist the colony in this difficult time. I am ashamed of the damage done to the lives of these people.
Farewell, Shiela.
Farewell, Commander. I wish you well in your hunt.
Thank you for everything you did.
Thanks, Commander. It's great to be free again.
You were at the Skillian Blitz, right? Never thought someone like you would help us.
I have my own thoughts again. Thank you, Commander.
Thank you for everything you tried to do here.
Free? I
think without pain. And with the power cells you brought, I can get this place up and running again. Thanks, Commander.
It will take time for things to get back to normal. Thank you for freeing us.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress.
Commander, you look pale. Are you suffering any ill effects from the cipher?
The cipher shook me up a bit.
I might be able to help you. I am an expert on the Protheans. If I join my consciousness to yours, maybe we can make some sense of it.
Do it. Hurry. We don't have much time.
Relax, Commander. Embrace eternity. Incredible. All this time, all my research, yet I never dreamed. I am sorry. The images were so vivid. I never imagined the experience would be so intense. You are remarkably strong-willed, Commander. What you have been through, what you have seen, would have destroyed a lesser mind.
Come on, get to the point. What did you see?
The beacon on Eden Prime must have been badly damaged. Large parts of the vision are missing. The data transferred into the Commander's mind is incomplete.
You must have seen something.
I was able to interpret the data relayed through your vision, what was there at least. But something was missing. Saren must have the missing information. Maybe he found another beacon. If we can find the missing data from your vision, I can... Oh. I am sorry. The joining is exhausting. I should go to the medical bay and lie down for a moment.
We're done here. Dismissed.
I've sent off the Pharos report, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
Commander, Exogeny should have told us about the Thorian. It would have made your job much easier.
You might have been able to capture it for study instead of destroying it.
The Thorian liked to enslave minds. Anyone who studied it would have ended up as one of its thralls.
Perhaps it's for the best, then. At least the colony was saved.
Of course it was saved. Shepard would go to any lengths to help a human colony.
Being human had nothing to do with it. They were in trouble.
Admirable. But sometimes Spectres have to make sacrifices. I hope you're willing to do that when the time comes.
Goodbye, Commander. We will be waiting for your next report.
Miss Williams, Commander, we need to talk. If we do not resolve this situation now, I am afraid things might become awkward.
Oh, awkward, huh?
I hope we can keep this civilized. I do not want things to become unpleasant.
Because it's been so pleasant between us lately. Look, somebody in this room needs to make a choice. It ain't me, and it ain't you.
Maybe we should try to work this out.
I think we must. I may not know much about human relationships, but I understand the concept of jealousy.
Jealous? Of you? You're not even our species.
Perhaps that is why you feel threatened. I am a rival unlike any you have faced before. Hostility is a common reaction to the unfamiliar.
Doctor, you keep smartassing me, I'll show you what my hostile reaction is like.
Both of you, settle down. We can handle this like mature adults.
This is stupid. We're not married, Shepard. You want to get involved with some alien? Go ahead. It's none of my business.
I never meant for you to get hurt. But Liara's the one I really care about.
Hey, we're all grown-ups here, right? Hope you two will be happy together. If you don't mind, I need to clean my gear.
I feel bad for her, Shepard. I hope she'll be okay.
Ash is pretty tough. She'll be fine.
I suppose you're right. I'm sorry you were put in this position, but I'm glad you chose me. I don't believe we should continue this discussion here in the comm room, Shepard. You know where to find me if you want to have a more private conversation.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
I've received some troubling information, Commander. We need your help. Someone is killing former Alliance scientists. There have been 4 deaths in the past month.
Former scientists? Sounds like someone has a project they'd like to keep secret.
All 4 scientists worked on a classified project on a coup. There was a brutal massacre there years ago. An entire unit was killed by Thresher Maws. It was classified as a natural hazard, but the project dates coincide with the attacks.
You think these scientists had something to do with the attack?
I'm not certain what I think, but it's worth investigating. There was one other scientist on the project, Dr. Wayne. I'm transmitting his last known coordinates. Good luck. Fifth lead out.
Thank you. Stay back! I've got no grief with you. All I want is this bastard.
Please! He's a madman! Mr. Toombs, you're insane! You need help!
It's Corporal! Corporal Toombs! You don't get to lie! Not today! Today it all comes out!
What are you talking about? Why do you want to kill this man?
Want? What I want is my life back. I want to go to sleep without screaming in my dreams. I want the people who sent me to Akuz brought to justice.
Can't you see that Toombs is crazy? Shoot him!
But if I can't get that, I'll have to settle for killing the men who took my life away.
What did the doctor do to you, Corporal?
We were on Akuz. When the Thresher Maws hit, my entire unit was wiped out. The Thresher Maws, the scientists were studying them. They let them hit our unit just to watch. I woke up in a holding cell. The scientists were delighted I'd survived. Now they had someone to run tests on.
You're killing them because they killed your unit.
You can't believe Toombs. He doesn't have any proof. I demand a fair trial.
Ever had Thresher Maw acid in your veins? I have. They wanted to see what it would do. They're part of some organization, Cerberus, that runs secret tests like this. They treated me like a lab animal. This is justice. This man deserves to die. So, are you going to kill me or not?
You're better than this, Toombs. You're not like them.
Don't tell me who I am. You got away with a few scratches and a scary reputation. The rest of the unit died, and I was tortured for years, Shepard. You can't judge me. You don't have the right.
Toombs, if I could have helped you on Akuz, I would have. All I can do is help now. Let me.
Okay. I'm no murderer. They couldn't make me one. Just as long as he goes to trial. Maybe the screaming will stop now. I don't know.
Those bastards can't hurt you anymore. Joker, tell the Fifth Fleet we need a ship for pickup.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
I reviewed your report on the situation, Commander. I'm glad to see you were able to take Dr. Wayne in alive. Now we can put him on trial and get some answers. Corporal Toombs seems to have found some closure. Hopefully with therapy, he'll have a normal life again someday. Thank you again for your assistance, Commander. Fifth Fleet out.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
I like talking with you, Liara, no matter what the subject.
You have been very understanding with me, Shepard. Very patient. I appreciate that. I know there are some strange beliefs about my people, I am familiar with the legend of Asari promiscuity, but those rumors have little basis in fact. When one of my people joins with an individual from another species, it is a very deep and spiritual exchange. We do not enter lightly into a union.
You make it sound almost mystical.
A true union goes far beyond an ordinary melding. It is a connection that transcends the physical universe. Two become one. Thoughts and senses merge, identities intertwine. Memories and emotions weave themselves together, becoming entangled in a single, rapturous whole. It is unlike any other experience. In some cases, it can be a truly life-changing event.
You Asari can live for 1,000 years. What happens when your partner grows old and dies?
Some unions are a single encounter between two willing individuals. But there are cases where an Asari and her partner choose to remain together. When that happens, we do not focus on the inevitable loss. Instead, we enjoy the time we are given. And even after a partner has passed on, a part of them lives on in us. The union is a connection that transcends both time and space.
Sounds amazing. Are you saying...
No! Oh, no! I am not very good at this, am I? I'm sorry, Shepard. I am trying to explain why I have been so... reserved. The union is more than just sex. It is the lifeblood of my species, the way we Asari evolve and grow as a society. That is why I have never... That is why we must choose our partners with great care.
Wait, are you saying this is your first time?
I am only 106, barely an adult by Asari standards, and I spend most of my time absorbed in my research. I never really thought about it. Not until I met you. You are very special to me, Shepard. But with all that's happened, Saren, the Geth, the Reapers, I do not know if we are ready for this.
These are dark times, Liara. Maybe once all this is over...
I'm glad you understand, Shepard. There is too much at stake. We need to put aside our personal feelings and focus on stopping Saren. I wish it did not have to be that way. But we all have to make sacrifices. Let's talk about something else.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.